Hi guys. How's everyone doing? Everyone staying home on this rainy day, I hope. So good to see you guys coming back and practicing. I don't know. Hi Laura. Oh God, so good to see you. Like here, well, your name popping up here. Hi Serb. Hi Natalia. Sugar Plum Fairy, a very cute name. Hi Kit. Hi Celine. So is anyone here? Hi Jack. Anyone here new to Jiva Mukti? I know Belinda isn't, or Colette. Or hi Leanne, happy Easter for sure. I was just talking about the Bhagavad Gita in on my page and the idea of sacrifice and how, yeah, we're all sacrificing something right now, right? But being able to connect with you guys like all the time, the fact that we have internet is just such an amazing experience. Like a quote I was gonna talk about was from Pema Chodron, and she says, how will we experience the world? Hi, it's your first time. I'll introduce Jiva in a second, but how will we experience the world a month, a year, or 5 years from now? Will we be even angrier or more grasping and fearful? Or will some shift have occurred? And this depends entirely on the tendencies we reinforce today. This depends on the tendencies we reinforce today. Hi, Arun. Hi, Natasha. So if this is your first time to Jiva, Jiva Mukti is based off the lineage of Ashtanga. So it is a dynamic practice. We move with a flow. If you're new, I would recommend you have blocks or books near you, but it's not necessary. I'll give you modifications, and for those who practice with me, like Sandra, I see you, Sandra. Hi, hi, Trace. Just, you know, your harder variation. My class is online, like teaching online for all of us. Hi, Leonie. Oh, happy birthday, Leonie. I'm gonna do that shout out. It's her birthday. Please check out her Qigong on Tuesday. Yes, happy birthday. But so this practice, like I'm gonna do the easier variation. Like all of us teaching online nowadays, it's like learning to teach again for us. It's really nerve-wracking, I'm not gonna lie. and so the way that I usually teach online is a lot easier because I'm not there to see your body. I can't really correct you. I will have a Zoom eventually so I can see each of your screens. But because I can't see you, we're gonna play it a little bit safe. But if you wanna go a little bit further and you have another variation to do, please, by all means, go ahead and do so. Hi, Valen, good to see you here too. So I just read a quote from Pema Chodron. How will we experience the world a month, a year, or 5 years from now? Will we be even angrier, more grasping and fearful? Or will some shift have occurred? Now this depends entirely on the tendencies we reinforce today. These days, I think it's like, I'm almost on like, how many weeks, right? I'm on like 28 or something. But my inspiration these days come from all these new practitioners, yogic practitioners, meditation practitioners. I just finished an abundance meditation by Deepak Chopra where you bring groups together, and it's come full circle where I have other friends who are coming back to me saying they just started. 21 days later. And this idea of all these people just connecting, and we're connecting through the internet, right? I remember back in the day, like 4 years ago, I got off social media because I wanted to disconnect. And now I'm connecting again through the internet. And we're connecting to the internet because it's like, will I let this situation, being at home, take over my mental health? Or will I let it evolve me? And evolving doesn't necessarily mean doing 5 or 6 classes, which is great if you are, keep coming back to your mat if that's what you need these days. But evolving, like one of our teachers, Janet, she, in the past 2 years that I've known her, she's such an inspiration. She's transformed so much, she's grown. And in these 2 weeks, she takes 2 hours every day to read. Like for 2 hours, phone off, no distractions, make sure, and I mean, we don't have many because we're home, but we actually do. Like the amount of times I've been reading and been like, oh, I forgot to do the laundry, or I forgot to tend to my plants. So she really sits there, she focuses, that is her priority. And so evolving for different people might mean different things. For people who put living this really big party life, maybe for you, taking this healthy pause by slowing down, one class, meditation, maybe that's it. There she is, hey Janet. And for some of you, maybe it is doing 5 classes a day because you finally get to do that, right? But it's about finally tuning into what we need these days. And so we're transcending past, with all of these practices, what we thought we knew, right? What we thought we knew, or who we knew, even. We're starting to let go of judgments of ourselves because we're able to spend time with ourselves, and maybe even judgments of the world as a big whole, right? And it is sad what is happening out there, and it is great that we are staying home and being part of the bigger picture, right? Being part of the solution by staying home. But it is also very exciting if we decide to, this depends entirely on the tendencies that we reinforce today. Now, I could talk to you guys forever, but I really have to get you into practicing. Get into a downward facing dog. And you guys go into your downward facing dog. Go ahead and move in your dog just to start off with. Start with your hands shoulder width apart. If your shoulders are tight, walk your hands out wider, index finger parallel, or slightly out again if your shoulders are pretty tight. Feet hip width apart, and if you look at your second toe, make sure they're parallel to each other. And if you know me and you've come to my class, your dog should be nice and long. If you know me, I have a Dachshund, so I like long dogs, okay? Make your dog long. And then pedal through your feet, move, fidget, do what you have to do to allow yourself to really be present, be here. And this observing, this noticing, this meditation, this stepping onto your mat once a day, like, we are here to amplify the amount of love on this planet by staying home, by practicing, by meditating, by being more in tune to ourselves, so we can come out of this and become a better version of ourselves. So instead of reacting, we practice, we meditate. We listen instead of jumping to conclusions now, right? We notice instead of judging, and then we open that space for healing. So again, we're here to amplify the love on this planet by practicing instead of reacting, by listening instead of jumping to conclusions, by noticing instead of judging, and then we open ourselves to a place of healing. Come forward into plank pose. Exhale, lower your knees, your chest, and your chin to the floor. Ashtanga Namaskara. So Ashta, 8, Anga, angle, Namaskara. When we think about Easter, when we think about sacrificing, this is actually a pose that is used in temples to bow down to deities, right? That idea of offering. Point your toes, inhale, slide through. Cobra pose, Bhujangasana. Just a baby cobra. Press your pubic bone down, push the top of the feet down. You want to strengthen your lower back for upward facing dog later. And exhale, tuck your toes under, push back, downward facing dog. So we let things be. And then eventually this mood or whatever is hanging on you that you're stuck in begins to dissolve naturally into this place of wholeness. And given any amount of time, right, any mood will eventually change. And we know that, especially if you're like, I need to go practice for 1 hour. But given any amount of time, 15 minutes, 10 minutes, 1 hour, any mood will change. And then another option always eventually arises. Inhale, come forward into plank pose. Exhale, lower your knees, your chest, and your chin to the floor. Inhale, slide through, Bhujangasana. Exhale, tuck your toes, push your hips back, downward facing dog. And as you push into your hands, feel your sit bones lift up higher, feel the heels reach back, like you're opening from inner to outer heels. one more time. Inhale, come forward into plank pose, and then lean the weight more forward onto the top of the toes. Push the floor away from you. Like Gabby says, push into that really heavy door. Inner elbows forward, lean forward, lean forward. Chaturanga Dandasana. If you've been doing my Surya Namaskar the whole week, you know what I'm talking about. Inhale, slide through, upward facing dog. Now engage your abdomen, pull your chest forward, collarbones back. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a deep breath in. And a deep breath out. Again, inhale. And exhale. Okay, lift your heels up, bend your knees. And inhale, step, hop, walk forward, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Go ahead and grab your opposite elbows. Hook your elbows from the top of your thumbs. If you have any lower back issues, you can go ahead and bend your knees, or if your hamstrings are tight, but if possible, try to work on inner kneecaps up, straighten the legs, and then really pull your elbows down to the sides of the body. Lengthen when your spine is long, let your head be heavy. Breathe here. And switch, bring the opposite elbow or forearm on top. Again, inner kneecaps up, and can you shift the weight forward into your big toes? Widen the back of the thighs, lengthen the side body down, let your head be heavy, pull. Notice how good it feels to open up through the back of your body. And then release your arms. Heel toe your feet out as wide as your mat. And bend your knees, come down into a squatting position. Brendan loves taking pictures of me whenever I'm lost enough. Inhale, lift your heart up to your thumbs. Breathe here, inhale. Exhale, one. Inhale, push your right palm into your left palm into your right. Lift your heart up to your thumbs. Exhale, two. Inhale. Exhale, three. Press the outer edges of the feet. Lift the arches. Lift the crown of the head up higher. Exhale, four. Inhale. Exhale, five. Hands to the floor. Lift your hips all the way up. Heel toe your feet together. Bend your knees slightly. One vertebrae at a time. Roll your spine all the way up till the crown of the head comes up last. Bring your hands at heart center. Lift your heart up to your thumbs. Close your eyes, bow your head. I'm facing you, but I want you to be at the top of the mat. So close your eyes. Take a few breaths here. Ground down through your feet. Elevate to the crown of the head. Right? Yoga is about finding that balance between opposite forces. Balance in our body. And for today's intention, I want you to think of someone or something that inspires you. I mean, you don't have to know them. It could be the nurses, the healthcare workers, or it could be someone that's close to you that's struggling in a hard time and doing the best they can with the tools they have. Open your eyes. Inhale, reach all the way up. Gaze at your palms as they press. Exhale, fold into your legs. Uttanasana, forward fold. Inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale, step or jump back and lower. Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, upward facing dog. Outer ankles in, straighten your arms. Pull the collarbones back, gaze up if you're ready. Exhale, downward facing dog, breathing here. Make sure your second toe is parallel. As you push the inner wrist down, press your sit bones up and back. Inhale, lift the heels up. Exhale, bend your knees, look forward. Inhale, quietly step, hop, or walk forward. Halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach all the way up. Gaze at your palms as they press. Exhale, arms by your side, Tadasana. Again, like that. Inhale, reach up. Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale, fold into your legs, Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, quietly step or jump back and lower, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana, engage your abdomen, lift your upper back off the lower back. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe here, inhale. Should sound like your exhale for one. Ujjayi breath. So Ujjayi means victory, right? Regaining that victory over the fluctuations of our mind, maybe over our mood. We're connecting everything, body, mind, spirit. One more inhale. Exhale, lift up your heels, bend your knees, look forward. Inhale, quietly step, hop, or walk forward, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, Uttanasana.
Inhale, reach all the way up. Gaze at your palms as they press. Exhale, arms by your side. Tadasana. One more like that. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Five breaths here. Push the heel of the hands forward. Feel the inner heels open. Feel the sit bones lift up higher, risen. Widen across the back of your shoulders so you're rotating your armpits to the heart. And then hug the upper arms in as you press back a little more. Inhale, lift the heels up. Exhale, bend your knees, look forward. Inhale, quietly come forward, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, reach all the way up, Urdhva Hastasana. Exhale, arms by your side, Tadasana. Inhale, hook your thumbs, reach the arms forward up, lift up your chest, arch back. Exhale, bend your knees, fold forward. Swing your arms behind you, interlock your fingers. Extend your arms and legs, let your neck relax. Inhale, hands to the floor. Step your right foot back and lunge. Exhale, lower the right knee to the floor. Point at your back toes. Now push into your back foot. Inhale, reach your arms up. Can you hook your thumbs and lift up through your chest? Arch back. Reach through your thumbs. Exhale, hands to the floor. Step back, downward facing dog. Inhale, come forward into plank pose. Push the mat away from you. Exhale, lower your knees, your chest, your chin to the floor. Inhale, slide through Bhujangasana, elbows in. Exhale, tuck your toes under, downward facing dog. Inhale, come forward into plank pose. Exhale, lower Chaturanganadasana. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Inhale, step your right foot between your hands and lunge. Exhale, lower the left knee to the floor. Inhale, reach your arms up, hook your thumbs, and lift up through your chest, arch back. Exhale, hands to the floor. Step back, step forward and fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, slightly bend your knees, hook your thumbs, reach the arms forward up, lift up through your chest, arch back. Exhale, bend your knees, fold forward. Swing your arms behind you, interlock your fingers. Extend your arms and legs, let your neck relax. Inhale, hands to the floor, left foot back and lunge. Exhale, lower the left knee to the floor. Inhale, reach your arms up, hook your thumbs, lift up through your chest, squeeze that left butt, press your left pelvis forward, push into the top of the back foot. Now lift your sternum higher and lean back more. Exhale, hands to the floor, step back, downward facing dog. Inhale, come forward into plank pose. Exhale, lower your knees, your chest, your chin to the floor. Inhale, Bhujangasana. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Inhale, step your left foot between your hands and lunge. Exhale, lower the right knee to the floor. Point your back toes. Inhale, hook your thumbs. Reach your arms up. Lift up your chest, arch back. Can you squeeze your right butt cheek? Push your right hip forward. Pull your arms in. Lift the sternum higher. Lean back more. Exhale, hands to the floor. Step forward and fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, slightly bend your knees, hook your thumbs, lift up your chest, arch back. Exhale, arms by your side, Tadasana. Inhale, bend your knees, rise up, Utkatasana, chair pose. Reach up your whole upper back, move your knees back, keep your big toes down. Exhale, belly to thighs, hands to the floor, push, Uttanasana. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, Chaturanganadasana. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Inhale, step your right foot forward, back heel down, rise up, warrior one. Exhale, open the arms and hips out to the side, warrior two. Now someone asked me to explain having 50% of the weight in the back leg. So you're gonna straighten your right leg, and then let's take the left foot in first, and we'll do triangle pose. So reach your right hand forward, lengthen. If you need a block, take it behind your foot, and then go ahead. Left arm up, right hand down. So right hip back, push into the inside of the right foot. Lift the inner right knee cap up, but feel like that inner left knee is lifting up as well. You're anchoring down through the outer edge of the left foot, and then spin your chest up to the sky. Just spin your chest up a little bit more. You wanna push into the left, right index knuckle, inner right elbow forward, and you're not collapsing into that right rib cage, but you're lifting up away. And then again, anchor through your back foot, spin your chest up. Inhale, pushing your feet, come up. Exhale, parallel your feet towards each other. Inhale, lift up through your chest, arch back. Exhale, fold forward over your legs. Start with your hands underneath your shoulders. And you can stay there if you need to. You can use blocks if you need to. If you are ready, walk your fingertips, step back. More land your toe tips or the heel of the hand or heels of the feet, and then lengthen the crown of the head down to the floor. So inner kneecaps up, widen the back of the thighs, sit bones lift up higher. Feel we shift forward. It's kind of like that Uttanasana earlier, right? And then if you're ready, crown of the head to the floor. Now if you can, and you promise you're not gonna break anything in your house, you may lift up into a tripod headstand. Breathe in. Ooh. Breathe out one. Inhale. Oh my goodness. Exhale two. Inhale. Exhale three. Inhale. Exhale four. Inhale. Exhale five. Open your legs out wide. Inhale, lift up halfway. Almost broke my door. Exhale, hands to the lower back, draw the elbows in. Inhale, pushing your feet, lift your chest, arch back. Exhale, arms by the side. So 50% of the way in the back leg. Turn your right toes out, maybe widen your stance, ankles directly in the wrist. Now feel like someone's pulling the inner left kneecap open, right? So the weight is in the left leg, and then bend the right leg. Bend it so you keep that 50% of the way in the back leg. Got it? When you're ready, right hand outside, right foot. Heel of the hand in line with the heel of the foot, left arm up and over your head. Stretch from your back foot to your fingertips. Rotate the tricep to your cheek, press your front knee open to your arm, and then peel the back of the right rib cage towards me. Breathe in and breathe out here. So the inner kneecaps are lifting up, or the inner thighs lifting up, back of the thighs down, and you're gonna take that right butt cheek and push it forward, and spin your chest up more. Sit a little bit deeper. One more twist. Good. Left hand down. Lower the left knee to the floor. Point your back toes. Inhale, lift up your torso. Interlock your fingers on your right thigh. Exhale, push into the top of the foot. If you need to tuck it under for more stability, go ahead and do that. Otherwise, try to point your toes, anchor through the top of the ankle. Now squeeze that left butt cheek like you want to take your tailbone to your front heel, and then sit a little bit lower. You can stay here with your hands on your thighs if your elbows are bent. If you can push your hands in your thighs and straighten your arms, you may always reach your arms up and back. Exhale, one. Inhale, ribs in, sternum higher, reach your fingertips. Exhale, two. Inhale, exhale, three. Squeeze that left butt cheek, left pelvis forward. Lift your lower abdomen away from thigh. Exhale, five. Hands to the floor with your inhale. Exhale, tuck your back toes under. Lift the left knee off the mat. Inhale, straighten your right leg. Walk your back foot in a little closer. Two heels in line. Halfway lift. Exhale, re-bend the right leg. Now square your hips off with your right knee bent. Right hip back, left hip forward. Feel the inner left kneecap lift up. Think of it again. 50% of the weight in the back leg. Inner left kneecap up. That awareness, that repetition that you constantly do. And then when you're ready, straighten your front leg. Full chin to shin. Great. Inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale, step back, lower, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Okay, other side. Inhale, left foot forward, back heel down, rise up, Virabhadrasana 1. Exhale, open arms and hips out to the side, Warrior 2. Inhale, straighten your left leg. Now you're going to take your right toes in slightly, push through the outside of the right foot, and then reach your left hand forward. Left hip back, left hand forward, lengthen through the left side. When you're ready, oh hi Kaya, I'm out of the way, Kaya. Oh, well, I guess you guys know your pose. So left hand down, right arm up. Push through your index knuckle so there's more of a back than behind the heart. Anchor through your back foot, push into the inside of the left foot, and then lift the inner kneecaps up. So the same idea like Tadasana, grounding down through elevate, and then spin your chest up higher. Good, inhale, pushing your feet, come all the way up. Exhale, parallel your feet towards each other. Bring your hands to your lower back, draw the elbows in. Inhale, lift up through your chest, arch back. Exhale, fold forward over your legs. So keep your hands on your back and keep drawing the elbows in. Now look down to the floor. inner kneecaps up, sit bones higher, pull your upper body down. It's like you want to pull your chin to the floor. And notice how much you have to engage your inner thighs and your lower abdomen to pull and fold deeper. Two more breaths. Pushing your feet, come all the way up. Exhale, arms out parallel to the floor. Take your feet a little bit wider, ankles directly under the wrists. Turn your left toes forward. Now keep your hips open. Remember, feel the engagement of the right leg, like the inner thigh is reaching up and back. Someone's pulling it, and then bend that left leg. So you're not just collapsing or bending the back knee, but both weights are equal in both feet. Now when you're ready, left hand outside, left foot. Walk if you need to. If your hand is flat on the floor, that's great too. Like I said, I'll show you the easier variation as there are newbies here. So with your left thigh parallel to the floor, reach your right arm up and over your head. Push down through your feet, lift through the left rib cage, peel the back of the left rib cage up towards the sky. Press that left knee open, take the inner left groin forward, inner right kneecap up, and again, spin your chest up to the sky. Wrap the right tricep into your cheek, stretch through that right side of the body, and then spin your chest up one more time, sit lower. Inhale, right hand down, lift back, heel up. Exhale, lower the right knee to the floor. Inhale, lift up your torso, interlock your fingers on your right thigh, left thigh. If you need to tuck your toes under for more stability, go ahead and do that. Otherwise, try to point your back foot. Now, anchor through the top of your foot. Squeeze your butt like you're tucking the tailbone under, right? Tailbone reaches that front heel, and then sit a little bit lower. Now, with your inhale, hands to your thigh. If you're ready, push your hands into your thigh. If you're ready, your elbows are straightened up, reach your arms up over your head. Now, wrists in, tailbone forward. Lift your upper back off the lower back, reach to your fingertips. Exhale, one. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale. Exhale, three. Inhale. Exhale, four. Inhale. Exhale, five, hands to the floor, tuck your back toes under, lift the right knee up. Inhale, straighten your front leg, walk your back foot in. Inhale, re-lengthen, re-bend the left leg, square your hips off. Exhale, straighten your front leg, chin to chin. Breathe in, and breathe out. Keep lifting both inner kneecaps up, press the outside of right foot inside left. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step back, lower, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Go ahead, inhale through your nose. Open your mouth, stick out your tongue, no one can see you, and go. Get it out, one more time, inhale. Open your mouth, stick out your tongue, exhale. Yeah, be silly. Inhale, lift up your heels. Exhale, bend your knees, look forward. Inhale, quietly come forward, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, bend your knees, rise up, Utkatasana. Exhale, come up to stand, Tadasana. Okay, so separate your feet as wide as your mat. If your heels are lifted, you may take a blanket underneath your heels or blocks under each of your heels or pillows, whatever you can find around you, sweater, anything basically. Just make sure your heels or your connection with the earth is nice and comfortable. Then come down back into Malasana. So if this is hard on your knees, you place a block underneath your sit bones, like that. And then you're fully supported and then you can open through your hips. Okay, so we've already been here. You know what we're gonna do. Take your left hand out to the left, straight arm, reach your right arm back and up, twist. For those who can take a bind, reach your left arm behind you, interlock your fingers, and then don't let your right knee drop in. Open your right knee out, lift the left rib cage higher, peel that right lung open, shift the weight to the heels, keep your big toes down, and then lift your upper back off the lower back. Again, inhale through that left rib cage, exhale, right lung opens more. Pull the right arm, can you straighten it? Inhale, left hand down, right arm up. Exhale, hands at heart center. Other side, bring your right arm in front of your right shin. Reach your left arm back and up, twist towards the left. So again, there's that tendency to just forget about that leg, or either of your legs actually. So inner kneecap opens, big toes down, more weight in the heels. You may stay here. For those who can, take a bind. Right hand grabs left wrist, onto all your fingers. Inhale, breathe into your right rib cage. Exhale, left lung opens. Heel open through that left bicep tendon. Feel the sternum lift up higher. Feel the weight in the heels, open your knees out wider and twist. Inhale, right hand down, left arm up. Exhale, hands at heart center. Inhale, hands to the floor. Exhale, lift your hips all the way up. Heel toe your feet about hip-width distance apart, parallel. Bend your knees, bring your hands to your lower back. Inhale, lift up your chest, arch back. Exhale, fold forward over your legs. Grab your big toes with a yogi toe lock. That's your peace fingers. And then you're gonna slide your yogi toe lock between your big and second toe. You can close it off with your thumbs. Inhale, halfway lift. Keep that length through the front of the body. Exhale, bend your elbows and fold. Inner kneecaps up, sit bones up, widen the back of the thighs, lengthen your upper back down. When your spine is long, let your head be heavy. And then maybe try not to let your hips go back. Lean the weight a little bit more forward into your big toes without letting your heels lift off the floor. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, bend your knees, hands to the lower back. Inhale, pushing your feet, lift up through your chest, arch back. Exhale, come back to center. If you're not there, go to the top of the mat. Tadasana. Inhale, reach up. Lord Bahastasana. Exhale, fold into your legs. Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, Chaturanga. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Inhale, step your right foot forward, back heel down, rise up, warrior one. Exhale, string your right leg, interlock your fingers behind your back. Take your right foot one step over to the right. Inhale, lift up through your chest, arch back. And exhale, breathe down the right leg, fold forward. Reach your hands away from the floor. Feel that in your right hamstring, the outer right glute, and then swing that right butt to the left. If the crown of the head is on the floor, that's great. But if it's not, you'll probably feel it more, right? More of an intensity, a stretch. So don't worry about not having your head to the mat. Keep that weight in your back leg, same idea. And then reach your hands a little further forward. Inhale, lift up halfway, lift your back heel up. Good, release your hands. Now lean the weight forward. Inhale, warrior three. Oh, I hate this pose. My right leg is so much weaker than my left leg. I mean, a lot of times we stretch and we open up our hips and our hamstrings, so this pose is not supposed to be easy for yogis. Okay, reach your heart forward, arms higher than your head. Push into that right big toe mound, pull right it back, and then straighten both your legs. Good, exhale, hands to the floor. Left hand down if you'd like, grab your right ankle, standing splits. Woo, or fall. Standing splits, lift the inner right kneecap up, or inner outer right hip up, and straighten both your legs. Inhale, halfway lift, open out your hip. Exhale, bend your knees like a curtsy. Come almost down to sit. Inhale, lift that left leg up. Open out your hip. Exhale, bend your knees like a curtsy. Almost down to sit. One more time. Inhale, lift that left leg up. Open, open, open. Left leg higher. Exhale, bend your knees. Come to sit. Left knee outside, right heel. Right hand behind you. Reach up to your left arm. Twist towards the right. If you cannot get your elbow outside there, hold the shin with your right arm. Pull it to the left. Lift that left rib cage up. Gaze over your right shoulder. Now peel the back of your left rib cage towards the right thigh. The front of the right rib cage behind you, lift the sternum higher, twist. Make sure you can feel both front of your sit bones on the mat. Inhale, come back to center. So we're gonna take an Adho Mukha Svanasana, ankle to knee pose. Right shin over left shin. Adho Mukha fire, so fire log pose. If you've ever seen a fire place, It's like two logs stacked on top of each other. So try to keep that bottom heel away from your sit bone. Inhale, sit up tall. Reach your arms up. Exhale, reach your right arm behind you towards the middle of the spine, and then bend your left elbow. If you cannot clasp your hands, that's okay. Hold your shirt and pull it in two different directions. So your hands are clasping, your shoulders are relaxed. Flex your feet, sit up tall. Some of you might stay here. You might need a blanket to sit on. If you're ready, hinge forward and fold. Stick your booty back, pull your chest forward, fold deeper. Lift up halfway, release your left arm. Release your right arm and fold. Inhale, come up to sit. Swing your right leg behind you, pigeon pose. So pigeon pose with your shin is parallel to the front edge of the mat. Plug that left hip back. Square your hips up, press the front of the shin forward and fold. If you would like, you can bend your right leg behind you and fold. Now you're gonna drag that right knee back, squeeze your right glute, and press the front of your right groin towards the floor. Hands to the mat, step back, downward facing dog. Inhale, step your left foot forward, back heel down, rise up, warrior one, square those hips. Inhale, straighten your left leg, interlock your fingers behind your back, switch the grip if you like. Take your left foot one or two steps over to the left, feel 50% of the weight in the back leg. Inhale, lift up through your chest, arch back. Exhale, rebend your left leg, fold forward. Again, feel the outer left hip and your left hamstring. Reach your hands up, pull the crown of the head down. If it is hovering, you will probably feel it more intensely. So maybe you want to find a way to widen your stance or challenge it, giving your body room to grow. And yeah, on this left side, there's usually one side which is weaker or tighter. Inhale, lift up halfway, lift your back heel up, release your arms. Now, feel your belly on your thigh, shift the heart more forward, inhale. Here we go, our favorite pose, warrior three. Now, outer right hip down, straighten your legs, lift the outer left hip higher, inner kneecaps engage. If you would like, reach your arms forward. And then hands to the floor. Right hand down, if you'd like, grab your left ankle, standing splits. Inhale, lift up halfway, open up that right hip. Exhale, bend your knees, almost to sit. Inhale, lift that right leg, open out your right hip. Exhale, bend your knees, almost to sit. Inhale, lift that right leg up, open, 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 open. Exhale, bend your knees, come sit down. Ooh, my butt, it's on fire. Here we go, twist to the left. Inhale, right arm up, twist. Again, if you cannot hook your elbow, if you want, you can always take a bind, you can hold the shin with your hand. Pull it to the right. Lift the sternum higher. Feel your chest back. Breathe in. Breathe out one. Feel the back of your right rib cage move towards that left thigh. The front of your left rib cage opens up more. Feel the front of your sit bones. As your sit bones ground down, lift your upper back up, twist deeper. Good. Inhale, center. Stack your shins. Agni, Stam, Basana. First, stack your shins again. If you're here, you might need to sit on a blanket. You can just hold your blanket or a pillow, something to lift your hips up. Don't be embarrassed to do that. Bring the earth up to you, right? Everything comfortable, steady, connection with the earth. So you can stay here when you're ready. Arms up, left arm behind you, find the middle of the spine. Right arm, so elbow next to the head, because we're working more towards that left arm. Inhale, sit up tall. Stick your booty back. Exhale, hinge forward. Especially in hip openers, I always feel that imbalance in each side. And just being aware of that balance, right? Like I said earlier, yoga is about finding the relationship between opposite forces. Lift up halfway, release your right hand, and then release your left hand and pull deeper. And realizing these differences that we have within ourselves. So we make them eventually integrate and work together harmoniously. Inhale, sit up tall. Good, and then swing your left leg behind you. Come into pigeon pose. Take the same variation you did on the first side. So I'm reading this book called Aware by Dr. Siegel. He's amazing. And he says that balance is a common term that we can understand scientifically is coming from this process that we are calling integration. So the allowing of things to be different or distinct from each other on the one hand, and then connecting them to each other on the other. And when we differentiate and link, we integrate. And so we become balanced and coordinated in life when we create integration. Pull a little bit deeper. And inhale, sit up tall, and exhale, step back, downward facing dog. Lower your knees to the floor. Swing your legs out in front of you. Sit up tall. Oh my god, we don't have much time together, guys. So sit up tall, bend your right knee, open the right knee out to the side. Janu Shirshasana. I see those hearts coming. Yeah, I miss you guys. Inhale, sit up tall and full. If you would like, you hold your foot. Try not to crisscross your wrist. Just hold your foot. If you want to hold the outside of the foot, I will give you the option to do that. If you want to take a bind, left hand grabs right wrist. Take a mudra of your choice. Fold here. So he continues and he says, likewise. This synergy of integration means that the many aspects of our lives, like the many points on like a rim of a circle, can each be honored for their differences, but then brought together in harmony. So the balance between each side of our body, we can appreciate them for their differences, but bring them together harmoniously. I mean, yoga does mean to yoke, right? To unify. Let's switch right knee up, right leg forward. Bend the left knee, open the left knee out. Inhale, sit up tall. Square off over your right leg. Take the same variation you did the first side and fold. If you're taking the bind, right hand grabs left wrist. Grabber is the grabber. Pull. Left shoulder down, fold. Straighten your left leg forward. Paschimottanasana. If you need to, and it's hard for you to hinge forward, I definitely suggest go ahead and sit on a blanket. If you need to go a little bit deeper and you have blocks, place the blocks in front of your feet. Place the blocks in front of your feet, and when you're ready, just fold here. We're going to take 15 breaths. Inhale and exhale, one. Inhale, exhale, two, inhale, exhale, three, inhale, exhale, four, inhale, exhale, five, inhale, lift up halfway, re-lengthen through the front of the body, and exhale, fold deeper. So coming back to our practice, or even distracting ourselves from being in that healthy stillness sometimes, right? Like holding a pose for such a long time. These familiar places, let's say on the edge of the circle, even if these sensations or thoughts, feelings arise from trauma and receiving suboptimal care, can ironically be more reassuring to people than entering into a state of uncertainty and freedom. And so the experience, this pattern of being drawn to that abused state of the mind, those repeated elements may involve what is some, for some is a passive victim stance, and for others maybe an active, angrily fighting back state. And these states reveal how we can become reactive in response to threat.
So these states reveal how we can become reactive in response to threat. And so sometimes, this is like a really important principle, because what is practice repeatedly, right? So when we come back to our mats, when we meditate, this strengthens our brain by firing clusters or patterns within us over and over again. And with repetition, and we always say this as yoga teachers, with repetition, that neural structure is literally altered. Literally altered. And this is how repeated states become enduring traits. So we want it to become your natural way of you. And so where attention goes, that neural firing flows and neural connection grows. Okay, inhale, sit up. And exhale, bend your knees. Have your feet about hip width apart and parallel to each other. If you'd like, you can always straighten your legs in like a reverse airplane. If you can, walk your hands behind you and ruler distance away, fingers point forward like your toes. Pushing your hands, puff up your chest. Exhale, chin down. Inhale, lift your hips up. Lift your hips up. Try not to squeeze your butt. Can you lift your tailbone up to your thigh? Can you push in your legs? Can you take your shins towards your upper back? Let's do that. Inhale, lift your hips up higher. Abba, lift your hips up higher. Liana, lift your hips up higher. Natasha, lift your hips up higher. Amadeo, lift your hips up higher. Hips up, hips up. Janet, lift your chest up. And then chin to chest, lower down. Come to lie on your backs. Lie on your backs. So lying on your back, we're taking Sittu Bandhasana. Bridge pose. Your feet are still hip width apart. You're just lifting up your lower back, your middle back, your upper back. Interlock your fingers under your back. If you can, press the outer shoulders down. Press the side of the pinkies down. Push your heels forward. Get your chest up to the chin away from the chest. Breathe there. Inhale. Exhale, one. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale, outer hips higher, inner heels down. Exhale, three. Inhale, shins towards your upper back. Exhale, four. Inhale, and exhale, five. Come all the way down. So good. Okay, so I will give you the option to come back into half wheel. For those who are ready, we're going to take a full wheel pose, which means you're going to place your hands next to your ears. Fingers point the same direction as your toes. So we all lift up about the same way. Take a moment here, just breathe, catch your breath, ujjayi. And then again, that repetition of coming back to being present, right? To allowing things to be as they are. And then naturally being with it allows it to become, go into a place of wholeness. Allowing to be in it in any amount of time, as I said earlier, then your mood changes eventually. You come up with other options, other perspectives. When you're ready, hands and feet, inhale, lift, full wheel. If you'd like, come to the crown of the head first. Turn your fingers out, elbows in, inhale, push, lift up. Exhale, one. Inhale, exhale, two. Inhale, exhale, three. Inhale. Exhale, four. Inner heels down, outer hips higher. Don't squeeze your butt. Take your shins to your upper back and push. When you're ready, chin to chest, lower down. Straighten your legs, straighten your arms. Bring your hands in prayer. Your thumbs to third eye center. Close your eyes. And come back to that person that inspires you. Your inspiration, something, right, that you are devoting these next two wheels to. We're putting them together in 10 breaths due to lack of time. Jivamukti is usually 90 minutes for those whose first time is here. But I want you to think about the person that you thought of at the beginning of class. Notice how already that changes your perception of how this wheel is going to be, right? You're lifting up with a place of love. And so without reacting, without anticipating how it's going to feel, without judging yourself, inhale, lift. Exhale, one. Inhale, exhale, two. I'll join you. Inhale, exhale, three. Inhale, exhale, four. Inhale. Exhale, five. If you'd like, come to the crown of the head. Walk your hands a little bit closer to your feet. When you're inhale, lift up again.
Exhale six if you can. Straighten your arms, straighten your legs. Exhale seven. Inhale. Exhale eight. What are you resisting? Open your heart. Exhale nine. Inhale. Exhale 10. Chin to chest. Lower down. Don't wrap your right leg over your left leg. Take your hips to the right. Lower your knees to the left. And just twist. No engaging, no controlling. Just let it soften into that space. To do shoulder stand or headstand if you already have it, okay? About 3 minutes. For those who've never done an inversion and you're scared to in your home, I would definitely get you to check out, I think Janet has one. Beginners upside down next week for 30 minutes. This is probably not the best place to in the next 2 to 3 minutes. I would love, if you need my help, definitely DM me and I'll go through it a little bit slower. But the first one is you can do Viparita Karani. So Viparita Karani means reverse attitude pose, right? It is so powerful, it is so simple, and it is so restorative if you can hold it for like 5 minutes or longer. If for whatever reason you cannot invert a moon cycle, then I would suggest you just keep your lower back flat on the floor, lift your legs up, or again, sit Devada Konasana. For those who are doing shoulder stand and you have tight shoulders, you can always use a blanket and you can place it about like 1/2 down, right? Pull up your mat, roll onto your back. Make sure you keep the natural curve of your cervical spine. You can roll back, rock side to side. Think about what you did in Setu Bandhasana. Hands frame your spine, one leg up, the other leg up. So that's shoulder stand. For those who are doing headstand, if you need a wall, knuckles all the way to the wall. Please, please, please be careful. Interlock your fingers, keep a space between your hands, elbows a little bit closer than the width of the shoulders because they do tend to splay out to the side, right? Then you're going to bring the crown of the head to the floor, tuck your toes under, walk your feet in, and you might just stay there. If you can, bend one knee, bend the other knee. If you can, bring the soles of the feet to the wall if you're against the wall. And if you would like, point your toes up to the sky. Push down through your elbows. Keep your index finger drawing it towards each other. And as you push in your elbows, feel your biceps move away from the forearms. Feel the inner ankles lift up. Remember, even in your inversions, you're grounding down to elevate. Grounding down to elevate, okay? So as you push in your elbows, you push down, what are you elevating? Your shoulders, your inner thighs, your sternum lifts, just like we talked about in Tadasana over the week. And then you breathe there. If you feel a bit shaky and you are upside down, I would definitely suggest you exhale longer. So finally, right, you come to the end of your practice. You embrace what is. And embrace what is and to know what happens. And in this level of acceptance, it correlates to the level of possibility that presents itself in regard to change. Because as Pema Chodron said, how will we experience the world a month, a year, or 5 years from now? Will we be even angrier, more grasping and fearful? Or will some shift have occurred? And this all depends on you, on what you decide to do, on the tendencies that you pick up, on the repetition, on the balance, and what you do and you reinforce today. And tomorrow, and the day after. Because
you know, we have never put our mental health first, but now we get the time to. So take advantage of that. When you're ready, come down, please. If you're doing shoulder stand, please go through the process of Halasana and Matsyasana. If you're doing headstand, take a child's pose. If you're in Viparita Karani, Supta Baddha Konasana, all the way down, soles of the feet together, knees out to the side. Now I need to close off because we only get 1 hour. but I'm going to invite you to take a child's pose here. If you're taking a child's pose, a Shavasana, if you're taking that, I would suggest you maybe even turn off the camera right now. You really, really, really deserve Shavasana. There's nothing better than having a long one. So even if you're not gonna do it right now and you wanna do it later in the day, do that for you. Because remember, we're putting ourselves first. I mean, it's not like we're really going out, right? So yeah, go ahead, lie down. There's no time for meditation, again, with 1 hour, but that's your homework, I guess. Can you meditate for like 3 to 5 minutes for me? Maybe before you sleep, maybe after this class, when you can. And hopefully I get to see you again next week. I hope it was good, especially for those who was the first time. Follow me on my Instagram. I have meditations every morning at 8:30 before the first class. I would love it if I could see your names again and see you join. If you want to just say hi and what's up, or you have something you want to talk about, also let me know. Hi, Shakin. So good to see you. Hi, Esther. Yeah, I miss you guys in the studio. I feel like teaching online is like the biggest challenge for me. I get very, very nervous, and so it's like I have to meditate and ground myself and do all these things. And I'm sure, it's all part of the practice, right? It's a new challenge, a new thing for a lot of us. Back foot 50%. Yeah, Juliana, hopefully you got it. If you're still confused, send me a message and I will take a video for you so you can see it a little bit more clearly, okay? Oh, nice, you came back, Sharana. But yeah, so Jivamukti here. My Dharma and the chanting is always on my personal one at 2:30. And then the practice itself is here. Like I said, Shavasana, please. Do it for as long as you can. You deserve it. And meditation, if possible, when and where you can. If you can't, just allow yourself to be still, even for 1 minute. Remember, any little amount of time makes a difference, just as long as you go through that repetition. Bye, I gotta go. I've only got 2 minutes, and I wish I could say, hi, Wayan, so good to see you. Hi, Tui-ing. Yeah. Oh, thanks. I hope I see you next week. Again, same schedule next week, every week. Awesome, Zeho from the UK. What time is it there? That's crazy. Hi, Annie, yo. Nana. Okay, gotta go. I'm getting a time going down. But stay healthy. Remember, this is a time you stay home, stay healthy. That means cook good food. Learn to cook if you have never cooked before. Recipes, if you want recipes, we have the internet. You can always Google things. If you want anything, please just let me know. Oh, so good, Tanya's all the way in Paris. Don't forget to check out Leonie on Tuesday. It is her birthday today. Send her a happy birthday message. 9 a.m. So cool, what good timing. Again, see you again, I hope. Always say what's up if you're coming to my meditation. I'll holler. Bye, Paywin.